Hi, in this video we are going to look at how we can use operational amplifier as an inverting and non-inverting amplifier. So basically we are going to use operational amplifier with a negative feedback. So let's first look at inverting amplifier, because this is the basic circuit for many applications. So if I have operational amplifier, this is non-inverting terminal, this is inverting terminal. The non-inverting terminal is grounded and a signal is fed through an input resistance, let me call it as R1, this is input, and I'm going to use a feedback resistance RF across inverting terminal and output terminal. So this is the basic circuit. Now let's understand this particular circuit and find out what will be the gain of this particular circuit. Now if I call it as point A, this as point B, and the current will be flowing in this particular direction, and this current I am going to call it as input current I1, and there will be some amount of current flowing through the feedback resistance. Since this will be a negative voltage, the direction will be in this particular direction, so this will be my IF, right? And since this operational amplifier has infinite input impedance or input resistance, because of that no current flows through the amplifier. Now this has two implications. The first implication will be that since no current is flowing inside this operational amplifier, whatever this I1, this need to be flowing in this particular direction, and because of that I'm going to have I1 is equal to IF. And the second implication is that I can use the concept of virtual ground, and VA is equal to VB. And as we know, this is connected to a ground terminal, so VA is equal to 0, so VB will be also equal to 0. So this is equal to 0. Now we are going to use this concept to find out the gain of this amplifier. So let's find out what is the value of I1. So the voltage I1 will be equal to potential drop across resistance R1, which is equal to Vin minus Vb divided by R1. So this will be equal to Vin divided by R1. Similarly, IF will be equal to Vb minus Vout divided by RF. Please look over here, across this resistance, the voltage over here is Vin, the voltage over here is Vb. For this resistance, the voltage over here is at this particular terminal will be VB, and at this particular point the voltage will be equal to V out. So at this particular terminal the voltage will be V out. Right? So that will be equal to, since VB is equal to 0, this will be equal to V out divided by RF. And as we know that I1 is equal to IF, this implies that Vin by R1 is equal to minus V out by RF, and therefore V out by V in is equal to minus RF upon R1, and this V out divided by V in, this is called as gain. Therefore the gain is equal to minus RF divided by R1. So for an inverting amplifier, the gain is given by minus of RF divided by R1. So there is a minus sign, please note over there. So because of that, what's going to happen if I have an amplifier something like this. So let's see the feature of this particular amplifier. Now suppose I applied a positive voltage over here, and if value of R1 is equal to, let's say, 3 kilo ohm, and RF is equal to 6 kilo ohm, then what is the value of gain? The gain will be equal to minus of 6 kilo ohm divided by 3 kilo ohm, that would be equal to 2, right? Now if Vin is equal to 2 volt, let's say, then V out will be how much? So I know that gain is equal to V out divided by Vin. This implies that V out will be equal to gain multiplied by Vin. Therefore V out will be equal to 2 volt input voltage multiplied by gain of 2, that would be 4 volt. What is gain? Is it positive? No, there is a negative sign. So I forget the negative signs over here. And similarly, there will be a negative sign over here. There will be a negative sign over here. So basically, in inverting amplifier, why it is called as inverting amplifier? Because if I apply a positive voltage at the input, the output voltage will be negative. And if I apply a negative voltage at the input, the output voltage will be positive. Similarly, if I apply a positive going signal, the output will be negative going. And if I apply a negative going cycle, the output will be a positive going, albeit with an amplified signal. So this is the feature of this inverting amplifier. So what are the features of this inverting amplifier? The polarity of output is opposite to the input signal. If input signal is positive, output signal will be negative. If input signal is negative, output signal will be positive. The second thing is that the gain can simply be controlled by changing the resistance. Now suppose if I have these sets of values, suppose I have fixed R1 and I am changing RF. So let's see what is the effect on gain. So when, let's say R1 is equal to 1 kilo ohm, 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 and I am just changing RF. Suppose RF is equal to 1 kilo ohm, 2 kilo ohm, 5 kilo ohm, 10 kilo ohm, 100 kilo ohm. What will be the gain? For this particular case, when R1 is 1 kilo ohm, RF is 1 kilo ohm, gain is minus RF upon R1. So the gain will be equal to minus 1. For this particular case, RF is 2 kilo ohm and R1 is 1 kilo ohm. So the gain will be equal to minus 2. For this particular case, the gain will be minus 5. For this case, gain will be minus 10. For this case, gain will be 100. So I can change the gain simply by changing the resistance values. So while using in a closed loop mode on operational amplifier, I can control the gain. It's not anymore infinite. I can choose whatever gain I want. This is the inverting amplifier. And this inverting amplifier, please note this particular thing, this is the basic circuit used in most of applications. How? That will be clear in a minute.